we have self-awareness, and our self-awareness is based on our ability to remember our past experiences. Have you ever wondered how our brain stores memories for a lifetime, while proteins in the brain only last for a few days and then decay? A 2018 study published in Journal of Cell can change your understanding of memories. An ancient virus might give our ability to remember. The ARC gene, or sometimes called ARC protein, is the key for long-term memory. If you remove ARC gene from mice, they look normal, but they cannot remember things that happened 24 hours earlier. A 2018 study found that the ARC gene or ARC protein not only looks like a virus, but also acts like a virus. Just like the way retroviruses infect host cells, ARC delivers genetic material and transfers information between brain cells. We haven't found any other non-viral protein acts in this way. Similar to the mitochondria in our cells that came from bacteria more than 2 billion years ago, the ARC gene seems to have come from outside too, from a virus. ARC gene is highly conserved in humans and birds, but not in fish. Researchers think that around 400 million years ago, our ancestors might get infected by an ancient virus, an early form of retrovirus. When the retrovirus infected the ancestor, it integrated its genetic material into our ancestor's DNA, creating a stable, long-term relationship. The collaboration with viruses might lead to the evolution of brains that allowed us to learn faster and remember things better. How we store memories for a lifetime. Studies found that memory is encoded by the patterns of interactions occurring between our brain cells or neurons. Think of an interesting moment from your childhood memory. That memory is actually associated with a specific pattern of how a group of neurons talk to each other in your brain. Synaptic plasticity, or neuronal plasticity, plays an important role here. Synaptic plasticity is change that occurs at synapses, the connections between neurons where information is transmitted. Specifically, when we experience a new event, a set of synapses are strengthened or weakened to encode our memories. In other words, the structure of your neural connections must dynamically change for memory consolidation. But how does this happen? This is where the ARC gene comes into play. Studies found that when we have intense brain activity, such as learning new things, the ARC gene is expressed at high levels in neurons. ARC helps to strengthen or weaken the synapses, which is the key for synaptic plasticity. Back to the interesting moment in your childhood, let's say that's a summer day a few decades ago. ARC gene helped regulate how neurons interact with each other to form the specific network pattern associated with that memory. The pattern can be stabilized into a very stable state, also known as an attractor. And then that memory is stored in your brain for a long time. Whenever you are replaying that interesting childhood memory in your mind, the neural network in your brain can find that specific pattern. So, the ARC gene is important for turning our experiences into long-lasting changes in the brain. A 2022 study showed that ARC is a master regulator controlling over 1,900 genes involved in neuronal plasticity. How does ARC gene work? The way ARC transfers information looks incredibly similar to the way that retroviruses infect host cells. ARC packages its genetic information, mRNA, in a virus-like shell called ARC capsid and sends it from one neuron to another. Think of these ARC capsids as cargoes that need to be transferred to destinations. The connections between neurons are like highways. When we experience new things, ARC capsids get triggered to exchange mRNA information between neurons. The targeted neuron cells are just like the destination cities. There are two main regions within ARC mRNA, coding region and untranslated region. In this workflow, the untranslated region gives very precise instructions regarding how to transfer and unload ARC capsids into targeted cells, just like a delivery instruction for the cargoes. As a result, messages and information are exchanged between different parts of the brain. What are the implications for us? As we learn more about ARC, we can not only know the mechanisms of memory, but also apply it to our life to improve brain function. Studies found that apart from memory, ARC may also play a role in other aspects of cognition, such as attention, reasoning skills, decision-making process, and regulating emotion-related behaviors. Dysregulation of ARC function is linked to diseases such as Alzheimer's. Enhancement of ARC function can improve synaptic plasticity, memory, and cognitive decline related to aging. Studies indicated that certain compounds and dietary or lifestyle changes might improve ARC function. In one study, calorie restriction in rats increased ARC expression. Hope you enjoyed today's video, and please let me know your thoughts and comments below. For more details, I have added some studies in the video description. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and share with your friends. Subscribe to the Health Megabyte channel for more videos like this.